Hi there, how have you been?
I am doing great. Thanks. How about you?
I am fine. I recently read a book about creativity.
Speaking of creativity, have you been to any art exhibits lately?
Yes, actually, I recently went to a contemporary art exhibit downtown. It was really interesting to see some of the new and unconventional ways that artists are expressing themselves.
That sounds really cool. Do you have a favorite artist or piece that you saw at the exhibit?
There was one installation that really caught my attention. It was a series of sculptures made out of recycled materials, like old electronics and scrap metal. The artist had created these incredible, intricate pieces that were really visually striking.
Wow, that sounds amazing. It's always inspiring to see artists using their talents to create something new and beautiful.
Absolutely. I think it's important to support the arts and encourage creativity in all its forms.
I couldn't agree more. So, have you made any travel plans recently?
Actually, I'm planning a trip to Europe next month. I'm really excited to explore some new cities and experience different cultures.
That sounds incredible. Where are you planning to go?
I'm going to start in Paris and then travel to Amsterdam, Berlin, and Copenhagen. It should be a really interesting mix of cultures and experiences.
I'm so jealous. I've always wanted to visit Europe. Maybe I'll have to plan a trip myself sometime.
You definitely should. There's so much to see and do, and it's always a great way to broaden your horizons and learn new things.
Speaking of learning, have you taken any language classes recently?
Actually, I just started taking a Spanish course at the community college. It's been challenging, but also really rewarding.
That's great. I've been thinking about brushing up on my French. Maybe I'll have to look into taking a class myself.
You should. Learning a new language is such a valuable skill, and it opens up so many new opportunities for travel and cultural exchange.
I completely agree. So, how about we grab some lunch and catch up some more?
That sounds like a great idea. I know a great spot just a few blocks from here.
Perfect, let's go.
Great, let's head out then.
So, what have you been up to besides traveling and taking language classes?
Well, I've been trying to be more involved in my community lately. I joined a local volunteer group and we've been doing some really rewarding work.
That's awesome. What kind of volunteer work have you been doing?
Mostly community service projects, like helping to clean up parks and organizing food drives for the homeless. It's been really fulfilling to give back in a meaningful way.
I can imagine. I've been wanting to get more involved in my own community as well. Do you have any advice for someone just starting out?
I would say just start small and find a cause that you are passionate about. There are so many organizations out there doing great work, so find one that aligns with your values and interests.
That's great advice. I'll have to look into some local organizations and see if there's anything I can do to help out.
Definitely. It's amazing how much of a difference you can make even with just a few hours of volunteer work.
I completely agree. So, what are your plans for the rest of the week?
Well, I have a few more classes to attend, but other than that, I'm pretty open. How about you?
Same here. I have some work to do, but I'm hoping to get outside and enjoy the beautiful weather we've been having.
That sounds like a great idea. It's important to take some time for yourself and enjoy the little things in life.
Absolutely. Well, we're almost at the restaurant. I'm getting hungry.
Me too. I think you're going to love this place. They have the best sandwiches in town.
That sounds amazing. I love a good sandwich. What's your favorite kind?
I'm a big fan of the classic BLT. How about you?
I love a good grilled cheese with tomato soup. But honestly, I'm not too picky. As long as it's delicious, I'm happy.
That's a great attitude to have. Speaking of attitude, have you noticed any changes in your mindset since starting your language classes?
Actually, yes. I feel like I've become more open-minded and curious about other cultures. It's amazing how much learning a new language can broaden your perspective.
Absolutely. It's one of the reasons I love traveling so much. Experiencing new cultures and ways of life can really expand your worldview.
That's so true. I hope to do more traveling in the future, once it's safe to do so again.
Me too. In the meantime, there are still plenty of ways to immerse yourself in other cultures, even from home.
That's a good point. I've been trying to watch more foreign films and listen to music in different languages.
Those are great ways to expose yourself to different cultures. I've also been trying to cook more international cuisine and learn about the history behind different dishes.
Oh, that's a great idea. Do you have any favorite recipes you'd recommend?
Well, I recently learned how to make homemade sushi, which was a fun challenge. And I've been experimenting with different Indian curries and spice blends.
Wow, you're really getting into it. I'll have to come over for a dinner party sometime.
Absolutely, I'd love to host. Speaking of which, we're almost at the restaurant. I hope you're hungry.
I am starving. Let's go in.
They enter the restaurant. And now, they're seated at a cozy table by the window.
So, what do you think of the atmosphere here?
I love it. It's so cozy and welcoming.
That's what I love about this place. It's not too fancy or pretentious, but the food is incredible.
Speaking of which, let's take a look at the menu. Oh, wow. These sandwiches sound amazing.
I told you, they are the best in town. I'm having trouble deciding between the roast beef and the turkey avocado.
Tough choice. I think I'm going to go with the grilled chicken with pesto.
Good choice. And we can split an order of sweet potato fries.
Perfect. And I think I'm going to try one of their specialty drinks. The lavender lemonade sounds really refreshing.
That sounds amazing. I might have to get one too.
After placing their orders, they continue their conversation.
So, what other hobbies or interests do you have besides volunteering and cooking?
Well, I love hiking and spending time in nature. There's something so calming and grounding about being surrounded by trees and fresh air.
I completely agree. I try to get outside and go for walks as much as possible.
That's great. And speaking of getting outside, have you ever tried learning a language through immersion?
Not really, no. I've always just taken classes or used language learning apps.
Well, immersion can be a really powerful way to learn a language. When you're completely surrounded by the language and culture, it can help you pick up on nuances and subtleties that you might miss otherwise.
That's a good point. Have you done any language immersion programs?
Yes, actually. I did a summer program in France a few years ago, and it was an incredible experience. I stayed with a host family and attended language classes every morning, and then spent the afternoons exploring the city and practicing my French.
Wow, that sounds amazing. How long were you there for?
Just 6 weeks, but it felt like a lifetime. I made so many friends and learned so much about the language and culture.
That's really inspiring. Maybe I'll have to look into doing something like that in the future.
I highly recommend it. And even if you can't travel, there are still ways to immerse yourself in the language. You can try watching TV shows or movies in the language, or listening to podcasts or music.
Yeah, I've been doing some of that already. I've been watching a lot of Spanish language TV shows on Netflix, and listening to Spanish music on Spotify.
That's great. And have you noticed any improvements in your language skills since you started doing that?
I think so, yeah. I feel like my listening comprehension has improved, and I'm starting to pick up on more vocabulary and grammar.
That's fantastic. It just goes to show that even small steps can make a big difference when it comes to language learning.
Absolutely. And I think it's also about having the right mindset. Instead of seeing it as a chore or something to check off a list, I'm trying to approach it with curiosity and enthusiasm.
That's such a great attitude to have. And it's something that can apply to all areas of life, not just language learning.
Yeah, I think you're right. It's about finding joy in the journey, instead of just focusing on the destination.
Exactly. And speaking of joy, here comes our food.
The server brings over their sandwiches and fries, along with the lavender lemonades. They take a moment to savor the delicious food.
This is amazing. I can see why you love this place so much.
Right. It's just the perfect combination of comfort food and gourmet flair.
And speaking of comfort, I have to say, this conversation has been really enjoyable. It's so refreshing to connect with someone who shares similar interests and values.
I feel the same way. It's been a pleasure getting to know you better.
Likewise. And I'm looking forward to staying in touch and continuing to support each other on our language learning journeys.
Definitely. And who knows, maybe we can even plan a language immersion trip together in the future.
I love that idea. Here's to many more adventures, both linguistic and otherwise.
They clink their glasses and continue to enjoy their meal, savoring the flavors and the company.
That sounds like a plan. But before we plan any trips, let's focus on getting more comfortable with the language. I've been trying out a new language exchange program where you can talk to native speakers of the language you're learning over video chat.
Oh, that sounds interesting. How does it work?
Well, you sign up and create a profile, and then you can browse through a list of potential language partners. You can filter by language, location, and interests, so you can find someone who's a good match for you.
That sounds like a great way to practice speaking and get some real-life conversation practice.
Exactly. And it's a lot less intimidating than trying to speak with a stranger in person, because you can do it from the comfort of your own home.
I'm definitely going to look into that. Thanks for the suggestion.
No problem. And speaking of suggestions, have you tried using any language learning apps?
Yeah, I've used a few different ones, but I haven't found one that I really love yet.
I know what you mean. There are so many out there, it can be hard to know which ones are worth your time.
Exactly. Do you have any favorites?
Yes, actually. I really like Duolingo for building up basic vocabulary and grammar, and then I use Memrise for more advanced vocabulary and phrases.
Oh, I've heard of Duolingo, but I haven't tried Memrise yet. I'll have to check it out.
Definitely. And there are also some great language learning podcasts out there that you might enjoy. Have you tried any of those?
No, I haven't. Do you have any recommendations?
Yes, I really like the Coffee Break series for Spanish. They have short, 20-minute episodes that cover different aspects of the language, and they're really well produced and easy to follow.
That sounds perfect for me. I have a short attention span, so anything that's bite-sized and easy to digest is great.
I know what you mean. And the best part is that you can listen to them on the go, whether you're commuting or doing chores around the house.
That's a great idea. I'm definitely going to add that to my language learning toolkit.
Awesome. And one last thing I wanted to mention is that it's really important to practice regularly and consistently. Even just 10 or 15 minutes a day can make a big difference over time.
That's a great point. I've been trying to make it a daily habit, but it can be tough to stick to sometimes.
I hear you. That's why it's helpful to find ways to make it fun and enjoyable, instead of feeling like a chore.
Yeah, that's something I need to work on. I tend to get bogged down in the details and start feeling overwhelmed.
It's all about finding the right balance between structure and flexibility. You want to have a plan in place, but also be willing to adapt and adjust as you go.
That's a great perspective. Thanks for sharing all of these insights with me. I feel inspired to keep working on my language learning goals.
Anytime. And remember, we're in this together. Let's keep each other accountable and motivated.
So, Nancy, tell me more about your experience working in the non-profit sector.
Well, it's been an incredibly fulfilling journey for me. I started out as a volunteer for a local charity and eventually worked my way up to a leadership position. It's been challenging, but the impact we've been able to make on the community has been so rewarding.
That's really inspiring to hear. I've been thinking about getting involved in some volunteer work myself, but I'm not sure where to start.
There are so many great organizations out there, it can be overwhelming to choose. Do you have any particular causes you're passionate about?
I've always been interested in environmental conservation. I think it's so important to protect our planet for future generations.
That's great to hear. There are plenty of non-profits focused on that issue. One that comes to mind is the Sierra Club. They have a lot of volunteer opportunities and campaigns focused on conservation.
Thanks for the suggestion. I'll definitely look into it. How do you balance your work in the non-profit sector with your personal life?
It can definitely be a challenge, but I make sure to prioritize self-care and set boundaries. I also have a great support system of friends and family who understand the importance of the work I do.
That's really smart. I've been trying to find a better work-life balance myself, but it's tough when you're passionate about your job.
Absolutely. But remember, taking care of yourself is just as important as the work you do. You can't pour from an empty cup.
Wise words, Nancy. Thanks for chatting with me and sharing your insights.
Of course, it was great talking with you too. Let me know if you decide to get involved in any volunteer work. I'd love to hear about it.
Thanks, Nancy. I really appreciate your insights. It's been great chatting with you.
Likewise, Ethan. It's always interesting to connect with someone who is passionate about making a difference in the world.
Definitely. Speaking of which, have you been following the news about the recent protests against police brutality and racial injustice?
Yes, it's been hard to miss. It's heartening to see so many people standing up for what's right.
I completely agree. I've been feeling inspired by the protests, but also overwhelmed by the magnitude of the problem. It seems like there's so much work to be done.
There definitely is. But I believe that every little action counts. It's important to remember that change doesn't happen overnight. It's a long, difficult journey, but it's worth it in the end.
That's a good point. What are some practical steps that individuals can take to help address issues of systemic racism and police brutality?
There are many things that people can do. For starters, educate yourself. Read books and articles about racism and inequality, and learn about the experiences of people of color. It's also important to listen to the voices of those who are directly impacted by these issues.
That's a great suggestion. Do you have any books or resources that you would recommend?
There are so many great resources out there. A few that come to mind are The New Jim Crow by Michelle Alexander, Between the World and Me by Ta-Nehisi Coates, and Stamped from the Beginning by Ibram X. Kendi.
Thanks for those recommendations. I'll definitely check them out. What else can individuals do to help?
Well, one thing is to get involved in local activism. Attend protests, write letters to elected officials, and volunteer for organizations that are working to address these issues. It's also important to have conversations with friends and family members about these issues, and to challenge any racist attitudes or behavior.
I agree. It can be uncomfortable to have those conversations, but it's important to speak up when we see injustice happening.
Absolutely. Silence is complicity, as the saying goes. It's important to use our voices to speak out against oppression and discrimination.
Speaking of using our voices, do you have any advice for people who want to speak up but don't know where to start?
Sure. One thing is to practice active listening. When someone shares their experiences of racism or discrimination with you, listen without judgment and try to empathize with their perspective. It's also important to acknowledge your own privilege and biases, and to be willing to learn and grow.
That's really insightful. I think it's important to be open to learning and growing, especially when it comes to issues of social justice.
Absolutely. And remember, it's okay to make mistakes. Nobody is perfect, and we're all learning as we go.
That's a good point. It can be hard to navigate these issues without feeling like we're going to mess up.
It's natural to feel that way. But as long as we're coming from a place of good intentions and a willingness to learn, I believe that we can make a difference.
Thanks for sharing that, Nancy. It sounds like you've had a lot of challenges to overcome. I'm really impressed by your resilience.
Thank you, Ethan. It hasn't been easy, but I try to stay positive and keep moving forward.
That's a great attitude to have. Speaking of moving forward, what are your plans for the future?
Well, I'm actually thinking about going back to school to get my degree in business. I've always been interested in entrepreneurship, and I think it would be a great way to use my skills and experience.
That's fantastic. What kind of business do you see yourself starting?
I'm not sure yet, but I'm thinking something in the healthcare industry. Maybe a home healthcare service or a medical supply company.
That's a great idea. I think there's a lot of potential in that field, especially with an aging population.
Exactly. And with my background in healthcare, I think I could really make a difference.
Definitely. Have you started looking into schools yet?
Yes, I've been doing some research and I've narrowed it down to a few options. I'm planning on visiting some campuses soon to get a better feel for them.
That's a smart approach. It's important to find a school that's the right fit for you. Have you considered online programs?
Yes, I have. I think an online program could be a good option for me, especially since I'll be working while I'm going to school.
That makes sense. Online programs can be really convenient and flexible. Just make sure to do your research and find a reputable program.
I will. Thanks for the advice, Ethan.
Of course. And let me know if you need any help or support along the way.
I will. Thanks again, Ethan. You've been a great friend and mentor.
You're welcome, Nancy. I believe in you and I know you're going to do great things.
You're welcome. Hey, do you want to grab lunch sometime this week? I know a great spot near campus.
Sure, that sounds great.
How about Wednesday at noon?
Okay, Wednesday works for me.
Great, I'll pick you up at your office at noon then.
Okay, sounds good.
Later that week.
Hi Ethan, thanks for picking me up.
No problem. You look really nice today, by the way.
Thank you.
So, have you been to this restaurant before?
No, I haven't. What do you recommend?
The burger is amazing. It's my favorite thing on the menu.
Okay, I'll have to try it then.
After lunch.
That was really good. Thank you for bringing me here.
Of course. Do you want to go for a walk around campus?
Sure, that sounds nice.
After walking around campus.
Thanks for showing me around. I didn't know there was a park here.
Yeah, it's a nice spot to relax. Do you want to sit for a bit?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Nancy, I hope this isn't too forward, but I really enjoy spending time with you.
I enjoy spending time with you too.
I was wondering if you'd like to go out again sometime.
I'd like that.
Great, how about we go see a movie this weekend?
Okay, sounds good to me.
After the movie.
That was a really good movie. Thanks for inviting me.
Yeah, I'm glad you enjoyed it. Would you like to grab some dessert before we head back?
Sure, I could go for something sweet. That was really good. Thanks for taking me out again.
Of course. I had a great time tonight.
Me too.
Nancy, I feel like I can talk to you about anything. You're a really great listener.
Thank you. I feel the same way about you.
I was wondering if you'd like to take a day trip with me this weekend. There's a town nearby that I've been wanting to explore.
That sounds like fun. I'd love to.
On their day trip.
Ethan, this town is really cute. I'm so glad you brought me here.
I knew you'd like it. This is one of my favorite spots.
It's definitely mine now too.
Nancy, I just wanted to tell you that I'm really enjoying getting to know you.
I'm enjoying getting to know you too, Ethan.
I hope it's not too soon to say this, but I feel like we have a connection. Would you like to be exclusive?
Yes, I would like that.
Few days later.
Nancy, do you enjoy reading books?
Yes, I do. I actually just finished a really good novel the other day.
Oh, that's great. What was it about?
It was a mystery novel. The plot was really interesting and kept me on the edge of my seat the entire time.
That sounds like my kind of book. I've always been a fan of mysteries and thrillers. Do you have any other recommendations?
Actually, I just started reading this new book called The Silent Patient. It's a psychological thriller, and so far it's really gripping.
The Silent Patient. I've heard of that one. It's been getting a lot of buzz lately. I'll definitely have to check it out.
You should. Let me know what you think of it once you finish.
I will. So, Nancy, what do you like to do for fun besides reading?
Well, I enjoy hiking and being outdoors. I also like trying out new restaurants and cuisines.
Oh, that's interesting. I'm not much of a hiker myself, but I do enjoy trying out new food. What's your favorite cuisine?
I love Mexican food. Tacos and guacamole are my absolute favorites.
Same here. There's this amazing taco truck down the street from where I live. You should come check it out sometime.
That sounds great. I'd love to. Maybe we can go there for dinner sometime this week.
I'd love that. How about Wednesday night?
Wednesday works for me. Let's meet there at 7.
Perfect. I'm looking forward to it. Nancy, do you enjoy reading novels?
Yes, I do. I actually just finished a really good novel the other day.
Oh, that's great. What was it about?
It was a mystery novel. The plot was really interesting and kept me on the edge of my seat the entire time.
That sounds like my kind of book. I've always been a fan of mysteries and thrillers. Do you have any other recommendations?
Actually, I just started reading this new book called The Silent Patient. It's a psychological thriller. And so far it's really gripping.
The Silent Patient. I've heard of that one. It's been getting a lot of buzz lately. I'll definitely have to check it out.
You should. Let me know what you think of it once you finish.
So, Nancy, do you work out or do any fitness activities?
Yeah, I actually do. I try to go to the gym at least 3 times a week.
That's great. What kind of workouts do you do?
Mostly cardio and some light weights. I like to run on the treadmill and do some interval training.
I see. I'm more of a weightlifting guy myself, but I do enjoy running outdoors when the weather is nice.
Running outdoors is definitely more enjoyable than being stuck on a treadmill.
Agreed. Have you ever thought about trying any group fitness classes? They can be a lot of fun.
I haven't. But I've heard good things about them. What kind of classes do you recommend?
Well, I've been trying out this new kickboxing class, and it's been a great workout. It's a lot of fun, and it really gets your heart rate up.
That sounds like a challenge. I've never done kickboxing before, but I'm willing to give it a try.
Awesome. Maybe we can go to a class together sometime. It'll be a great way to switch up our workouts.
That's a great idea. Let's plan on it.
Have you ever considered doing any kind of strength training?
Not really. I always thought that lifting weights was only for guys and that I would get too bulky.
That's a common misconception, but it's not true. Strength training can actually help you build lean muscle and increase your metabolism, which can lead to greater fat loss.
That's interesting. I never thought about it that way.
Plus, as you get older, it's important to maintain your muscle mass to keep your body strong and prevent injuries.
Yeah, I definitely don't want to lose strength as I age. What kind of strength training do you do?
Mostly compound exercises like squats, deadlifts, and bench press. They work multiple muscle groups at once and are great for building overall strength.
Those sound intimidating.
They can be at first. But with proper form and technique, they can really help you see results.
I'll have to think about it. Maybe you can show me some of the basic moves sometime.
Of course. I'd be happy to help. We can even do a few bodyweight exercises at home to get started.
That sounds like a good idea. I really want to challenge myself and see what I'm capable of.
That's the spirit. It's all about pushing yourself outside of your comfort zone and taking on new challenges.
Speaking of challenges, have you ever done any kind of fitness competition or event?
Yeah, I've done a few obstacle course races and a couple of powerlifting competitions.
Wow, that's impressive. How did you do?
I did pretty well. I placed third in my weight class in one of the powerlifting competitions, and I've completed all the obstacle course races I've signed up for.
That's amazing. I've always wanted to try a Spartan race, but I don't know if I'm ready for something that intense.
You never know until you try. If you want, we can train together and get you ready for the race.
That would be awesome. I think having a training partner would help me stay motivated and accountable.
Definitely. Let's plan on it.
A week later.
Hey Nancy, how's your fitness routine going?
It's going pretty well, actually. I've been trying to incorporate more strength training into my workouts, and I think it's paying off.
That's great to hear. I've been thinking about getting more serious about my own fitness routine, too. Do you have any tips for me?
Sure, I'd be happy to help. One thing that's really helped me is setting specific goals for myself. For example, I wanted to be able to do a certain number of push-ups and pull-ups by a certain date, so I structured my workouts around those goals.
That's a good idea. I've always found it hard to stick to a routine without a specific goal in mind.
Yeah, it can be tough. But another thing that's helped me is finding workouts that I actually enjoy. For example, I really love dance-based workouts, so I've been incorporating more of those into my routine.
That's a good point. I think I need to find something that I enjoy more, because right now I just find working out to be a chore.
Definitely. And don't be afraid to mix things up, either. Trying new things can keep your routine fresh and interesting.
That makes sense. I've been wanting to try rock climbing for a while. Maybe I should finally give it a shot.
Absolutely. That sounds like a lot of fun, and it's a great workout too.
Thanks for the advice, Nancy. I'm feeling more motivated already.
No problem, Ethan. I'm always here to help. And if you ever need a workout buddy, I'm happy to join you.
That sounds great. Maybe we can try that dance workout you were talking about.
Definitely. I think you'll love it.
So, have you ever thought about trying a group fitness class?
Honestly, not really. I usually just do my own thing at the gym.
I get that, but sometimes it can be fun to mix things up and try something new. Plus, you can meet new people and make some gym buddies.
I guess that's true. What kind of classes do you take?
I like to do a mix of things, but lately I've been really into spin classes. It's a great workout, and the music is always so energizing.
Spin classes, huh? I've always been a little intimidated by those. I'm not sure I could keep up.
Trust me, you can. And even if you can't keep up at first, that's okay. Everyone has to start somewhere.
I'll think about it. Do you have any other favorite classes?
Yeah, I also like to do yoga and kickboxing. They are both great for relieving stress and building strength.
I've done some yoga before, but I've never tried kickboxing. It sounds intense.
It definitely can be, but it's also a lot of fun. You get to punch and kick things, which can be really cathartic.
Maybe I'll give it a try sometime. Thanks for the suggestions, Ethan.
Of course, anytime. And if you ever want to try a class together, let me know. It's always more fun to have a workout buddy.
That sounds great. Maybe we could try a spin class together.
Absolutely. I'll look up the schedule and we can plan a time that works for both of us.
Sounds like a plan. I'm looking forward to it.
Me too. It'll be a great workout and a chance for us to hang out outside of the office.
Agreed. I think it's important to have some work-life balance, and this could be a great way to do that.
Definitely. And who knows, maybe we'll even become gym buddies and try out all sorts of classes together.
That would be awesome. I'm excited to see where this takes us.
I've been practicing yoga for a few years now, and it's become a regular part of my fitness routine.
Interesting. I've always been into more high-intensity workouts, like running and weightlifting.
Yeah, those are great too. It's all about finding what works best for you and your body.
Absolutely. I've actually been trying to increase my flexibility lately, so maybe yoga could help with that.
Definitely. Yoga can be really beneficial for improving flexibility and range of motion.
And what about strength training? Is yoga enough for building muscle?
Well, it's not necessarily a traditional strength training workout, but certain poses can definitely help build muscle and improve overall strength.
Got it. I'm definitely open to trying it out. Do you have any recommendations for a beginner like me?
I would start with a beginner-friendly class, like Hatha or Vinyasa, and focus on proper form and breathing techniques. And don't be afraid to modify or take breaks when you need to.
Thanks for the advice. Maybe you can come to a class with me sometime.
Absolutely, I'd love to.
Thanks, Nancy. I've been working out regularly for years now. It's become a part of my lifestyle.
That's great. I've been trying to get into a fitness routine myself, but I find it hard to stay motivated.
It can be tough at first, but once you start seeing the results, it becomes addictive. What kind of exercises do you enjoy?
I like doing yoga and going for walks, but I've never been much of a gym person.
You don't have to go to the gym to get in shape. There are plenty of bodyweight exercises you can do at home, like push-ups, squats, and lunges.
That's true. I guess I just need to find what works for me.
Exactly. It's all about finding something you enjoy and can stick to. Have you thought about trying a fitness class or hiring a personal trainer?
I've considered it, but it can be expensive.
It can be, but investing in your health is worth it in the long run. Plus, there are plenty of free resources online and in your community that you can take advantage of.
That's a good point. Maybe I'll look into that.
Definitely. And if you ever want some workout tips or motivation, I'm happy to help.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
No problem. We can even work out together sometime if you'd like.
That sounds like fun. Maybe we can even try a new class together.
I'm down for that. It'll be a good challenge for both of us.
Agreed. I'm looking forward to it.
Me too. It's always more fun to work out with a buddy.
Definitely. Thanks for being my fitness buddy.
Anytime. We'll get you in shape in no time.
Hey Nancy, have you given any more thought to visiting the UK with me?
Actually, I have. I think it would be a great experience to visit a new country and immerse myself in the culture. When were you thinking of going?
I was thinking of going in a few months, maybe around September or October. That way we can avoid the summer crowds and still catch some of the nice weather.
That sounds perfect to me. What kind of things did you have in mind for us to do while we're there?
Well, I was thinking we could start in London and do some sightseeing, like visiting the Tower of London, Big Ben, and the British Museum. And of course, we have to have some fish and chips while we're there.
That all sounds great. But what about outside of London? Are there any other cities or areas you want to explore?
Yes, definitely. I was thinking we could take a trip up north to Manchester and Liverpool. They have a really vibrant music scene there, and I think you'd enjoy that.
I'm sure I would. And what about the countryside? I've heard the UK has some beautiful landscapes.
Yes, that's definitely true. We could take a train to the Lake District and do some hiking there. Or we could rent a car and drive down to Cornwall and visit some of the picturesque coastal towns.
Wow, there's so much to see and do. I'm really excited about this trip now.
Me too. And since we'll be speaking English the whole time, it'll be a great opportunity for you to practice and improve your language skills.
That's a good point. I'm looking forward to challenging myself and learning more.
I'm glad to hear it. And who knows, maybe we'll even come back with some new accents.
I highly doubt that, but we'll see.
You never know. But seriously, I think it'll be a really fun and enriching experience for both of us.
I agree. Let's start planning and make it happen.
Definitely. I can't wait.
That's true. I'm going to miss the warm weather and sunshine here in California. But I'm excited to see our family and friends back in the UK.
Definitely. And it'll be nice to have some proper fish and chips again.
Yes, I've missed that. And I'm also looking forward to exploring some of the old castles and historical sites in the UK. We don't have anything like that here in the US.
That's true. We could even take a road trip and visit some of the famous sites in Scotland or Ireland.
That's a great idea. We could rent a car and make a whole adventure out of it.
And we could even stop at some of the small villages and try some traditional food.
Sounds perfect. I'm really excited for this trip now. It's going to be great to be back in the UK.
Me too. And who knows, maybe we'll even get to see some of our old classmates and catch up with them.
That would be amazing. I can't wait to share stories about what we've been up to these past few years.
It's going to be a great trip. I'm so glad we decided to go back and visit.
Same here. It's going to be a great way to end our time here in California before we move back to the UK permanently.
And who knows, maybe we'll even decide to move back sooner than we thought after this trip.
Who knows? But either way, I'm excited to see what the future holds.
I understand, but I don't think I could just uproot my life and move to another country like that.
I know it's a big decision, but we could have so many opportunities in the UK. Plus, it's closer to my family and friends.
I get that, but what about my job here? And our home? It's not like we can just leave everything behind.
I've already started looking into job opportunities for you in the UK. And as for our home, we could rent it out and use that income to help us get settled in the UK.
I don't know, it just seems like such a big change. And what about the kids? They have friends here and are doing well in school.
I understand your concerns, but I think it would be an amazing adventure for our family. Plus, the kids are young enough that they could easily adapt to a new school and make new friends.
I see what you are saying, but I need some time to think about it. Can we discuss this more later?
Of course, I don't want to pressure you into anything. Let's talk about it more when you're ready.
Thank you for understanding, Nancy. It means a lot to me.
Of course. I just want what's best for our family, and I believe that moving to the UK could be a wonderful opportunity for us. But we'll take it one step at a time and make sure it's the right decision for everyone.
Agreed. Let's take some time to think about it and talk more later.
Sounds good to me. And remember, no matter what we decide, we're in this together.
You're right. That's a good point. But I think it's important for us to take risks sometimes.
I agree with you. We need to take risks in order to achieve our goals.
Exactly. And besides, if things don't work out, we can always come back to the UK. We have our families and friends here, and we can always start over.
That's true. And I've always wanted to experience living in a different country.
Me too. And I think we can learn a lot from living in a new place. We can learn about different cultures, meet new people, and learn new things.
I think you're right. And I know that moving to a new country won't be easy, but I'm willing to take that risk with you.
That means a lot to me, Nancy. I'm excited to start this new chapter of our lives together.
Me too, Ethan. I can't wait to see what the future holds for us.
And who knows? Maybe we'll even pick up some new skills and hobbies while we're there.
That's a great idea. I've always wanted to learn how to surf. Maybe we can take lessons together.
That sounds like a plan. And I've always wanted to try my hand at painting. Maybe we can take a class together.
I like the sound of that. We can have our own little adventure in a new place.
Exactly. And I think it will be good for us to step out of our comfort zones and try new things.
Agreed. I think it will be an exciting journey, and I'm glad we're taking it together.
Me too, Nancy. Me too. Hey, Do you think we will move to somewhere else in future?
Well, I'm not really sure yet. I do love London, but I've also been considering moving to Bristol or Bath. Have you been to either of those places?
Yes, I've been to Bristol a few times. It's a really cool city with lots of art and music. Bath is beautiful too, but it's a bit smaller and quieter.
Bristol does sound interesting. What about the cost of living there compared to London?
It's definitely cheaper than London, but it's still a city, so it's not super cheap. But there are some nice neighborhoods that are more affordable. Plus, the quality of life is really good there.
That's good to know. I definitely need to do some more research before making a decision. What about you, Ethan? Have you thought about moving back to the UK?
Yeah, I have actually. I miss it a lot, and I think it would be nice to be closer to my family. Plus, there are a lot of job opportunities in my field in London.
That's true. Would you want to live in London again, or try somewhere new?
I think I would want to try somewhere new, maybe somewhere in the north of England, like Manchester or Leeds. I've heard really good things about those cities.
Oh yeah, I've heard Manchester has a great music scene. And Leeds is supposed to be really up and coming.
Yeah, exactly. Plus, the cost of living is much lower than London, so I think it would be more manageable.
Well, it sounds like we both have some decisions to make. But it's nice to know we're both considering moving back to the UK.
Definitely. It would be great to be back in our home country again.
Wow, it feels so good to be back in the UK after all these years.
Yeah, it's great to be back. I can't wait to explore everything again.
Same here. I've missed the British culture and people so much.
Definitely. I've also missed the food. I can't wait to have some fish and chips and a proper English breakfast.
Haha, me too. But we should also try some of the new places that have opened up since we left.
That's a good idea. We can start with some of the trendy restaurants in London.
Speaking of London, do you want to stay there for a few days or head straight to our hometown?
I'm not sure. I do miss our hometown, but I also want to take advantage of being in London and see some of the sights.
I agree. Maybe we can stay in London for a few days and then head to our hometown. It's only a few hours away by train.
Sounds like a plan. What do you want to do first in London?
I've always wanted to go on the London Eye. It's supposed to have a great view of the city.
Oh, that sounds fun. I've never been on it before either. Let's add it to our list of things to do.
Definitely. And we should also go to some of the museums and art galleries. London has some of the best in the world.
Agreed. I want to see the British Museum and the National Gallery.
Great choices. We should also check out some of the smaller galleries and exhibitions that are on.
Yeah, there's so much to see and do. It's going to be a busy few days.
But a fun one, for sure. I'm just happy to be back and experiencing everything again.
Me too. It's going to be a great trip.
It's great to be back in London, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been so long since we've been here.
I know, I've missed this city. It feels like home.
Definitely. What do you want to do first?
Let's drop off our bags at the hotel and then maybe grab some lunch at that pub we used to go to.
Sounds good to me. And then we can walk around and see what's changed since we were last here.
That's a great idea. I'm excited to see some of the new neighborhoods and check out the new restaurants.
Me too. I've been doing some research and there are so many new places to try.
And we definitely need to hit up some of our old favourites too. I'm already craving some fish and chips from that little spot near our old flat.
Yes. And we have to go to that park we used to go to all the time. Remember how we used to have picnics there?
Of course, that was one of my favourite things to do. I can't wait to relax there again.
Me neither. It's going to be so nice to just wander around and soak up the atmosphere.
Definitely. And we have a few weeks here, so we can really take our time and enjoy everything.
Agreed. I'm so glad we decided to come back and visit. It feels like we're coming home.
Few days later.
Hey Nancy, how's your day going?
Hi Ethan, it's going pretty well. How about you?
I'm doing great. So, what's new?
Not much, just getting settled back into life in the UK. How about you?
Same here, just trying to get back into the swing of things. I've been catching up on some work and getting back into my fitness routine.
Oh, that's great. I've been trying to get back into a fitness routine too, but it's been tough with the jet lag and everything.
Yeah, I know how you feel. It took me a few days to get over the jet lag, but now I'm feeling pretty good.
That's good to hear. What kind of workouts have you been doing?
Mostly weightlifting and cardio. I've been trying to mix it up and keep it interesting.
That sounds like a good plan. I've been doing some yoga and Pilates classes, but I want to start incorporating some strength training as well.
That's a great idea. It's important to have a well-rounded fitness routine.
Definitely. So, have you been able to explore any new places since you've been back?
Not yet, but I'm planning on it. There are so many great restaurants and museums in London that I want to check out.
Oh, I love exploring new places too. Let me know if you need any recommendations.
Thanks, I definitely will. How about you? Have you been able to do any sightseeing since you've been back?
A little bit. I went to see the Tower Bridge and the London Eye with some friends last weekend. It was really fun.
Oh, that sounds like a great time. I've never been to the London Eye, but I've heard it's amazing.
It really is. You should definitely check it out sometime.
I will, for sure. So, what do you have planned for the rest of the week?
Just some work stuff and maybe a couple of workouts. How about you?
Same here. Just work and hitting the gym. But I'm hoping to squeeze in some fun stuff too.
Yeah, me too. It's important to have some balance in life.
Absolutely. Well, it was great catching up with you, Nancy.
You too, Ethan. Let's grab lunch sometime this week.
Sounds like a plan.
Ethan, I can't believe how much your business has grown. You've become so successful.
Yes, it's been quite a journey. But I have to admit, it feels good to see all the hard work paying off.
I'm so proud of you. You've worked tirelessly to get to this point.
Thank you, Nancy. I couldn't have done it without your support and encouragement. You've been my rock through it all.
Of course, Ethan. I've always believed in you and your abilities.
And now that we're financially secure, we can start thinking about our future. We can travel more, buy a bigger house, and give our daughter everything she needs.
That sounds amazing. But let's not forget about the importance of saving and investing. We should make sure our financial future is secure as well.
Agreed. I've already been looking into investing in some new ventures. And I'm thinking about starting a foundation to give back to the community.
That's wonderful, Ethan. I know you'll make a positive impact with your wealth and success.
I want to use my success to make a difference in the world. And I couldn't have done it without you by my side.
You're always thinking about others, Ethan. It's one of the things I love most about you.
And I love you, Nancy. You've been my partner through thick and thin, and I can't imagine doing any of this without you.
I love you too, Ethan. Let's celebrate our success and look forward to a bright future together.
Nancy, can you believe we finally own our own island?
It still feels like a dream come true. I never thought we could actually pull it off.
Yeah, it was a lot of hard work and saving, but I think it's worth it. This place is stunning.
Absolutely. The clear blue water, the white sandy beaches, and the lush greenery, it's all so breathtaking.
And the best part is, we can make it whatever we want. We can build our dream home, have a farm, start a business, or just enjoy the peace and quiet.
I love the idea of having a farm. We could grow our own fruits and vegetables, and maybe even raise some animals.
That sounds great. And we could also invite our friends and family to visit and enjoy this paradise with us.
Definitely. I can already imagine hosting big barbecues, parties, and even weddings here.
The possibilities are endless. But first, we need to start planning and making some decisions. Where should we build our home?
I think that spot over there, by the beach, would be perfect. We can wake up to the sound of the waves every morning.
Agreed. And we can also build a dock for our boats, and maybe even a small marina for tourists.
Oh, and we could have our own little restaurant or bar, with a stunning ocean view.
You're full of great ideas, Nancy. This island is going to be amazing.
I can't wait to get started. Let's make this the best investment we ever made.
Definitely. And who knows, maybe one day we can even rent it out as a vacation spot and make even more profit.
Sounds like a plan. Let's get to work.
Can you believe it, Nancy? We actually own an entire island now.
It's amazing, Ethan. I can't believe we were able to make this happen.
Yeah, it's been a long journey to get to this point, but it's all been worth it.
Definitely. It's going to be the perfect place for us to get away from everything and just relax.
And think about all the possibilities for the island. We could turn it into a resort or even a nature preserve.
I like the idea of a nature preserve. We could make sure the island stays protected and preserved for future generations.
That's a great idea. And we could also use it as a place to host events and retreats.
Yes, that would be amazing. We could bring people from all over the world to experience the beauty of the island.
And we could use the income from the events and resort to support environmental causes and give back to the community.
I love that, Ethan. We can use our success to make a positive impact in the world.
That's the goal, Nancy. To create something beautiful and meaningful that will last for generations to come.
I'm so excited to get started on this new adventure with you, Ethan.
Me too, Nancy. This island is going to be the perfect place for us to create something special together.
Okay, let's stick together and search for any clues or anything unusual.
Agreed. I have a feeling that we're being watched.
What makes you say that?
I don't know. Call it a gut feeling.
All right, let's keep our eyes peeled. We don't know what's out here. Do you think we should head back to the house and call for help?
No, I don't want to take any chances. Let's keep moving forward and stay alert.
Okay, but promise me that we'll leave immediately if things start to get too dangerous.
I promise, your safety is my top priority.
Thank you, Ethan. I know I can always count on you.
Of course, that's what partners are for.
They spent few hours around the trip and heading back to the house.
I must say, dearest Nancy, our journey has been quite a remarkable one.
Indeed it has, my love. We have encountered our fair share of trials and tribulations, but we have also experienced some of the most breathtaking moments of our lives.
It is as if fate has conspired to bring us together and guide us through this adventurous path.
Perhaps it is so. But what truly matters is that we have stood by each other's side through thick and thin, and have emerged stronger for it.
Agreed. And as we stand here on this beautiful island, gazing out at the endless ocean before us, I cannot help but feel a deep sense of gratitude for everything that we have been blessed with.
As do I, my dear Ethan. We have built a life filled with love, laughter, and endless possibilities.
And the best part of it all is that we have each other. Now and forever.
Yes, my love. Forever and always.
So the story end here. What do you think? Please leave a comment and tell me what you think. I hope you enjoy it and keep learning.